Hi, I'm Mary Leisenring. Did you know that the official poverty rate in 2020 increased by 1 percentage point since 2019? Every year, the Census Bureau releases the national poverty statistics from the Current Population Survey Annual, Social, and Economic Supplement, or CPS ASEC for short. In this data gem, I will teach you how to access various types of poverty data tables for the nation and states. Let's get started. Let's start by going to census.gov. Hover over Browse by Topic in the top left corner of the main navigation bar and click on Income and Poverty. Select Poverty from the list of subtopics. On the Poverty page, select Data from the menu on the left. On the Poverty Data page, you may find links to data tables, data tools, and data sets. In this data gem, we will explore the different types of data tables available so you can easily determine which one meets your data needs. Clicking on Poverty Data Tables leads you to a page to download poverty statistics tables for different years. We measure poverty two ways every year. The official poverty measure is based on cash resources. The supplemental poverty measure uses cash resources and also includes non-cash benefits and subtracts necessary expenses, such as taxes, medical expenses. For official poverty estimates, there are report tables from the Annual Income and Poverty Report based on the latest CPS ASEC data. Detailed tables that offer poverty statistics across different groups, historical tables that show poverty trends over time, and poverty threshold tables. For supplemental poverty estimates, there are report tables from the Annual Supplemental Poverty Measure Report based on the latest CPS ASEC data and poverty threshold tables available. Let's start by accessing Supplemental Poverty Report data tables. Report tables include tables found in the Annual Supplemental Poverty Measure Report. If you're interested in downloading the most recent Supplemental Poverty Measure Report, you can find the link to the publication at the top of the Related Information menu here on the right. The types of tables available in the report may vary across years. In this list, you may also find the SPM poverty thresholds. For instance, in the 2020 SPM report, you find two adult, two child poverty thresholds in Table 3 and SPM thresholds by metro area. Click any link to download the table in an Excel format. Let's go back to the Poverty Data Tables page to show you how to access data tables for official poverty estimates, as poverty status may differ across different subsections of the population, such as race or gender. Report tables include tables found in the Annual Income and Poverty in the United States report. If you want to download the most recent Income and Poverty Annual Report, find it here under Related Information. These types of tables available in the report may vary across years. Simply click the link to download the data table you're interested in as an Excel file. To find detailed tables, return to the Poverty Data Tables page and select Current Population Survey Detailed Tables for Poverty. There are over 40 types of detailed poverty tables available to download that show the distribution of poverty status for different groups of people. Start by selecting the type of detailed table you are interested in. If we select POV-01, this table shows the distribution of reported poverty status in 2020 by age and sex of all people, family members, and unrelated individuals. You may also specify the current population survey reference year if you're interested in earlier years. After selecting a table, there are several iterations you may choose from depending on the poverty population you're interested in. For this table, iterations are available for populations between below 50 to below 200% of poverty and by race. For example, clicking on below 100% of poverty will take you down the page where you then have 9 racial categories to choose from. Clicking the link will allow you to download the Excel file of the table. Click the back button 2 times to get to the tables that contain historical poverty data. The Census Bureau began collecting poverty data in 1960 for the year 1959. Historical tables are useful for seeing how poverty trends have changed across time. There are 25 different types of historical data tables that are updated with every CPS ASEC data release to include the most recent year. Footnotes referenced in the historical poverty tables can be found at this link for CPS historical poverty footnotes under the related information menu on the right. Footnotes may provide helpful information on how race categories or survey instruments have changed across the years. Simply click on the link of a table to download the historical data table as an Excel file. The final poverty data table is poverty thresholds. Returning to the poverty data page, start by navigating to the poverty thresholds page. Poverty thresholds are the dollar amounts used to determine poverty status. The Census Bureau assigns each person or family one out of 48 possible poverty thresholds. Thresholds can vary by the size of the family and the age of the members. The same thresholds are used throughout the United States. They do not vary geographically. Thresholds are updated annually for inflation using the Consumer Price Index for all urban consumers. Although the thresholds, in some sense, reflect a family's needs, they are intended for use as a statistical yardstick, not as a complete description of what people and families need to live. On the Poverty Thresholds page, poverty thresholds by size of family member and number of children are specified by year. You can click to download the poverty thresholds for your year of interest as an Excel file.
I hope you found this information helpful. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about the latest income and poverty report for the 2020 CPS ASEC data, download the full report from the Census Bureau website. To learn more tips and tricks about how to access Census Bureau data, visit census.gov/academy and subscribe.